That's right, and welcome to Our Reviews Will Kill You. We are going to go right into this one. We're going to give you a hot, steaming take on Wonder Woman 84, the newest big release on HBO Max that just came out on Christmas Day. We're doing this a little bit after that. This will be a spoiler-heavy review, and we're going to get right into it. I'm the man you may know as Z, joined by Noob Noob and Scott. And if you listen to our podcast, you heard our non-spoiler review where Noob Noob and I called it a hot steaming pile.
It was
of
a hot Carl.
Carl.
It was a hot Carl.
Yes,
fucking
and
sucks.
Scott just absolutely loved it.
Which Scott is loves hot Carl.
Mind baffling to me. So why don't we get right into this? Directed by Patty Jenkins, the writer. Well, I don't know if she wrote. She did write part of this. I'm pretty sure she did.
She
some of the
was
screenplay.
A Patty.
And she's the, you know, director of the original Wonder Woman movie, also directed Monster. But this was amateurish at best. The acting was wooden, especially from all of the, every scene was stilted. I thought this was just from the beginning, this movie was terrible. The first 10 minutes made no sense. Tell me, Scott, what's the theme of the first 10 minutes of this movie? Why should we care about Wonder Woman?
The first 10 minutes of her as a young child battling through the competition.
Which we already saw.
Well, we saw pieces of it. It was just a reminder of that. Yeah, it may have been over-exaggeration digging into that.
They just wanted to bring back the stars of that, like the Connie Nelson.
Yeah, it was just a way for them to throw back the old stars. And they added absolutely nothing to her arc. Was there a theme that was tied to the end of this movie that came from that first scene?
From the first scene?
Yes, because that's supposed to set up the entire movie.
Yeah, she was wishing for greatness from the very start, and you learn that it's not just a wish that makes you great.
I'm pretty sure that's not what happened.
Don't think that has anything to do with it.
No, exactly, she was told she shouldn't cheat.
Yes.
And cheating is bad.
Don't be a bitch.
Don't be a bitch and don't cheat, and you'll do great things, Diana. That's exactly what she said.
While eating her Lucky Charms.
While eating her Lucky Charms. That accent was pretty terrible, just as bad as mine.
Yes.
So I don't understand. You know, normally there's some sort of thematic thing that goes through this. And the MacGuffin is the dumbest MacGuffin I have ever MacGuffined in a MacGuffin.
The Wish Genie?
It's about a wishing gem.
The Dreamstone, which has made multiple appearances throughout all of Justice League, was brought up by Dr. Dream, created by multiple characters, led to the death of multiple characters as well.
We're talking about the movie here.
Been inside the entire Justice League mantra for years.
Who made the Dreamstone, Scott, in the movie?
In the movie, it was made by the god, what's his name? Freya.
They never tell you.
No, they do. They do. While she's reading the book.
The Duke of Deception.
The god. The god of deception. Freya.
They do not go into any detail on that.
They
totally gloss
they
over that.
They say it. She says it while she's reading the book.
Who is it? They don't. What god
the
of
The god.
What?
It's a god. And she turns around. She's like. No, she turns. She's like, oh my god, if it was made by this god, this is really bad because this is the god of deception. This is basically the Loki of DC universe, Greek mythology in DC universe.
I must have been like Cheetah and just left during that part because that was not very clear.
It was plenty clear. I'm telling you. You know how it was clear? Because I'm telling you, it was clear. It was in the movie.
Okay, so explain to me how does this thing work? This dream MacGuffin.
The Dreamstone, which appeared multiple times throughout history at the fall of every civilization.
We're talking about the movie you just watched.
In the movie I just watched?
No one else, including Patty Jenkins, read a single Wonder Woman comic book.
Jeff
Johns co-wrote it, but he doesn't know anything about it. He allowed Justice League to happen. He doesn't know anything.
That's fair.
Well, every time someone makes a wish with the Dreamstone, it grants your wish, but at a higher cost than what the wish is worth. That's how the Dreamstone works, and that's how they explain
when you
it
wish,
in the movie.
The wall comes up, and the wall takes away your water. How does the wall take away your water again?
The wall showed up where the river was.
Mm. So it just took away
your
water.
So there was a river around the entire
nation
Cairo.
Of whatever.
Yeah, and the wall popped up and shut off everybody from the outside.
Nope.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's a wall, the water usually runs deeper than a wall. So
I mean, this was magic.
This was a magic wall. A magic wall that pops up, and you're questioning that?
This
made no sense. It's magic.
She was defeated by the power of magic, right? Because Wonder Woman didn't actually do anything to win at the very end of this. She did nothing.
She was hot.
She united the planet.
Through
that no one seems to remember that, 20 years later.
And there's no camera because she destroyed the camera. Didn't she destroy the camera that was transmitting this?
Yeah, what was she talking to?
Who was she talking to?
No, she didn't destroy the camera. She had the lasso on the guy's leg. It was still transmitting the whole time.
She smashed the camera before she went up to Lord, and he jumped into the beam of light that DC is known for. You always got to fight those beam of light.
There were 80 cameras in the room. She might have smashed one. It was still transmitting.
No, she destroyed the only camera that was pointed. This is the 80s, man. This isn't like 100 million. Okay, fine. Why was it in the 80s? Can you explain that to me?
Actually, it wasn't really in the 80s. In the very beginning when they were in the mall, it was more like the 60s. So they were kind of off with that one. And then later, they did make it more like the 80s. So this is the 80s.
Wonder Woman, it's time for 84, Scott. What part of 1984
the most 80s part of that movie was that mall scene?
No, the mall scene was the 60s, dude.
What?
Yeah. You were disqualifying yourself from this conversation.
This is from people who were alive during that time. The mall was more in the 60s, and then after that, it turned more into the 80s when they got into the planes and the subway and everything else. The mall may have been over exaggeration, but the rest of the movie was in the 80s.
The mall had women in spandex doing yoga. That didn't happen in the 60s, Scott.
Yes, that happened in the 60s.
Women couldn't vote in the 60s.
Yeah, so what makes you think that they could sit around in a circle and do yoga in the middle? Everybody was wearing parachute pants. Why would you think that was the 60s?
It was, so what? So it was a colorful over-exaggeration. And yes, I can see that if we're used to the Justice League and the dark tone they've taken, that this movie is going to be a shock to the system with how colorful and bright it was and cartoony it was. But it was, that's what Justice League is supposed to be.
So how did she lose? Okay, so she gives up her powers, but instead of it being instant like a giant wall, hers is gradual. Where she can
give up.
Use her powers as long as the plot says it's okay for her to use.
She didn't give up her powers. They were being drained from her as part of her wish. It was because when you make a wish, something gets taken away. For her, it was her powers which were being taken away.
But when everyone else makes a wish, Maxwell Lord's like, I'm going to take that shit immediately.
Some were instantaneous. Others were not instantaneous.
They were all instantaneous.
No, they weren't all instantaneous.
She just wasn't quite instantaneous.
No, they weren't all.
Maybe the wishes that happened before he absorbed the dream.
That was before the
dream pickle was absorbed.
Once Maxwell became more powerful and was able to actually start manipulating things, a power he didn't understand, it became more instantaneous.
Why, as this thing
started and as they were starting to make wishes, a lot of it was very, very slow. A lot of these, the things that came back, the things you gave up, happened very slowly.
Even though Steve instantaneously came back to her. But he did not instantaneously get Wonder Woman's power.
He didn't instantaneously come back. He came back like a day or two later.
No, he said he was stalking her from an apartment.
Oh, yeah. So he came back right away, but took him time to find her. But that was her wish. The wish is granted instantly, but the drawbacks, the things you give up, happen over time.
So how much of her power did she lose? Because she could make the invisible plane invisible.
Probably about, 50-60% by the time she said, I take the wish away.
So you have to define the plot logic, because the plot does not define any of this logic.
The plot defines it fine. It was a Justice League movie. This was more of a Justice League movie than any of the crap we've gotten before.
What are you talking about?
So no other members of the Justice League are in it, but it's a Justice League movie?
Yeah.
Because she ran like the Flash, like she was skating?
Yes, because she skated like the Flash.
Because it was a colorful, overly dramatic, magic-filled rampage that went over the top at times, and just everything wrapped around back to like it never happened before. That's how every Justice League story has ever happened, from the cartoons to the comics to everything else.
But why did it act like it not happened? Like, why do people just magically forget that
they don't remember the
wishing?
Because this is Justice League universe. Because if you watch any of the Justice League cartoons, the Ultimate Justice League, Justice League Ultimate, any of those things, the cartoons, the comic books, everything else, all this shit happens, and then later on, it's just kind of they forget about it and they move on to the next story.
So you're like, saying that they don't care about continuity.
No, it doesn't matter about continuity. It's about this big magic thing, and then they move on to the next one.
Even though this is clearly put in the DCEU.
It was written after the DCEU. They probably didn't have the storyline set up when they're writing the first Justice League crap or the first Wonder Woman. They put the story in there later.
Nobody wrote this. This was written by children.
So they use the Dreamstone as a reason to bring back Chris Pine. What? But the Dreamstone was an already existent object in the Justice League
universe.
That's
not the point. Scott, the point is that this movie had no coherent plot.
Also, what was Maxwell Lord's point?
What was his point? What was his motivation? What's his character arc?
Power. He wanted more power. He wanted to be famous. He wanted to be rich and famous and have all the power. And once he started getting power, he wanted more and more power as it went along. To the point that it got out of control for him.
Why was he dying?
Because the stone was taken away from him. As his wishes were being granted, the stone was also taken away from him. He was also being embodied by a mythical stone. Of course it's going to start killing you.
Are you assuming this or were you told this?
Who gives a shit?
Assuming it. You're assuming all of this. You're going off of your knowledge of DC.
Did it take away from the story that the stone was killing him in the long run? No.
Yes.
No, it didn't.
Okay, so when he asked the one guy, have I already asked you for a wish? And he goes, yes. And that he goes, all right, I don't need you. But then he goes to Cheetah and she gets to make two wishes. How does that make any damn sense whatsoever?
Because, all right, fine. So there's little plot holes here and there. You're nitpicking all these little things. Oh, my God. The one car was orange when it was supposed to be blue. Who gives a crap? It was a good movie overall. So what? So Cheetah got one wish earlier, okay. And then when he now embodied the stone, she was able to get another wish out of it.
Let me ask you this. If you're a pilot in 1918, do you think you could fly a jet today? You think that's possible? Yeah. If you've never flown a jet
into
before?
Fireworks?
The basics are the same. And yeah, you probably should not fly a jet into fireworks.
Slowly and just admire them. Instead of having your engine blow up and kill both of you.
That's actually very much something you don't want to do is fly a jet into fireworks.
A bad idea. So does that make him a good pilot or a bad pilot?
Makes him a great pilot. He was able to fly an invisible jet through fireworks.
Here's the plot logic. Maybe Steve Trevor didn't really care because he wasn't technically alive because it was another person.
Yes, he did steal another man's body, which is pretty creepy.
Yeah.
It's not like he stole it on purpose. He just woke up.
This is true. Then why was Max Lord asking him what did he wish for if he's not even a real person?
I just remember the ending scene where she sees the dude that took over.
Yes.
So like now that I just realized that dude went to Pound Town on her.
He has no idea.
Poor guy. That poor guy.
No idea.
Oh, man.
That's a sin.
Yeah.
Right,
he completely does not know that he got to pound Gal Gadot.
Oh, that poor guy.
Oh, how about that stretch of an hour with no action in it? Was that good for you, Scott?
That's why it was nice to have it on HBO Max where you could hit pause and go steal your beer.
The action scenes were so poorly directed. They wish they had Zack Snyder back because they were so off. That mall scene was a laughable. First of all, when did she become Superman where she just runs around saving random people? That's not really a Wonder Woman thing, which is fine. She could be Superman. I don't care.
She was doing that because if you look at the Justice League movie, Batman has images of her saving people over time.
So she cares about getting pictures sometimes, and she'll sit for selfies sometimes, but other times she's whipping cameras like they're no tomorrow.
There's also the thing where she basically is Superman because she flies at the end of this movie.
She's not flying. She's falling.
She's flying.
No, that's flying. That's gracefully falling.
Nope, she was flying.
She can fly in lore. So when did she forget?
She also forgot that like 30 years later.
No, yeah, she forgot
manipulating the air.
She had terminally ill disease.
She was able to use the whip to escalate and launch her further into the sky, but she was floating on the air.
Why are you whipping lightning?
She was gliding. She was gliding. She wasn't flying. There's a difference between flying and gliding.
Also, the big deal was made about her golden armor that served no purpose.
None. It stopped all of humanity from beating that one woman to death, but couldn't stop a cat woman from beating her up.
Yes.
Because all of humanity was this mortal man, whereas Cheetah, now endowed with Wonder Woman's actual powers...
Except she could be electrocuted, but Wonder Woman can't be electrocuted because she was holding her underwater.
Yeah, I kind of questioned that too.
And they have the same powers.
Yeah, I kind of questioned that too.
Okay. And what about the fact that she was beating up cops in the White House and then literally yells at Cheetah 2 minutes later in the same scene where Cheetah's beating up cops, but it's okay if Wonder Woman does it, but if Cheetah does it, it's not good.
Wait.
What?
Because if Cheetah was looking to kill them, not just beat them up.
All she did was throw them against the wall, and she's pulling out chairs for these.
At that speed, probably would have killed him. The chair saved his life.
Apparently.
And speaking of Cheetah, when she gets her second unnecessary wish, when she asks to be an apex predator, how does that equal a cheetah?
Yes, how does that equal a cheetah?
Because she was a cheetah in the comics. That was a poorly written line, I guess.
Yes. And she looked dumb as fuck.
Oh my God. That was the dumbest. First of all, the CGI and the costume she was in didn't even match. The scene lasted all of 2 minutes. If that. Those guns that she had, I'm pretty sure didn't exist in the 80s, or the guns that were shooting at Diana when she flies in. All of it, just not good. Just not good. She cannot defeat the power of wishes other than talking to wishes.
Yes. And no one remembers the wish again.
The wishening. No,
it wasn't the power of wishes. It was a power of wish granted by this stone that was created by the god of mischief back in the ancient times that had already taken out multiple civilizations.
How did that guy that they went to magically know? Who? There's so much wrong with this. I was going to take notes, but I was like, this movie is too stupid for me to take notes.
And also, the only way to reverse the wishes is by rescinding them. You think every human being on Earth rescinded their wishes?
Literally, after Cheetah told her, she literally beats Cheetah almost to death, and she goes, I'm not going to rescind my wish. And then she gives her little speech, and then you don't hear her rescind her thing. She just stops doing it.
Because you're supposed to have faith in humanity, that humanity would actually take this message and want to rescind and live and create a better planet for all of us, which is why this is completely written in fiction.
I just feel like they ruined Pedro Pascal, and they ruined Gal Gadot,
and they ruined Chris Pine.
They ruined his Asian son, which they never explained. Why did he have an Asian son?
That he didn't love, clearly.
He did not love.
But then
love
he, at the end, he's like, you know what? I kind of love him.
I'm a bad dude. I'm a liar.
Where was the mother? Was the son not adopted?
I don't know.
Dude, who knows?
Was the mother of Asian?
An Asian son like, with a white name.
Why are we questioning the ethnicity of the son?
Because it's something they deliberately put in that was clearly an important plot point that they didn't explain because they explained nothing in this movie.
At no point did I question why is his son a different ethnicity. No one cares.
It doesn't make any sense.
You're picking apart this movie for every little nut and bolt when if you just sit there and accept it for a movie and just get lost in it and just
because it was an hour-long sequence of no action in a giant tentpole action movie with Wonder freaking Woman, the most powerful woman on Earth, who doesn't do anything other than get shot a couple times at the end of the movie. She literally does nothing wonderful.
Linda Carter comes in, though.
Yes, ultimate spoiler at the very, very end. Linda Carter comes in and does nothing. She was apparently hysteria.
She saved the baby, but pointless.
Yes. She saved the baby. This movie was garbage.
It was hot, though.
Yes.
This was a good movie. This was a fun movie. And that's all it was. It was just a fun movie.
Can you give me one example when it was
fun?
And if you tell me the clothes dressing part, there's something wrong with you.
Chris Pine rediscovering the world after being gone for 40 years.
because a trash can didn't exist back then. Motorcycles didn't exist in 1918. Trains didn't exist in 1918.
I'm shocked.
I've never seen a train before.
The subway didn't exist. Jet engines didn't exist.
If you saw a spaceship
art in that form, really fast,
would you be shocked or would you just be like, wow, that's really cool?
I think I appreciated
the part in the space station. In the space part, I could genuinely get his shock at the fact that humans went to space. But a frickin' trash can.
The escalator.
The escalator. He's acting like an escalator couldn't exist.
No.
Oh my God, it's a miracle.
And if you told me 20 years ago that we would have this device in our hands that can access anything in the world, I'd say it was bullshit too. If you fast forward me, be like, I'd be amazed at this thing.
No.
There were no walking. There were no automatic stairs in World War II, and he just jumped into a world where there were automatic stairs.
It wasn't in World War II.
It's a cute moment. It was World War II. Yeah.
No, it was not World War II. It was World War.
What war was it?
1918. World War.
What war was it?
We looked it up before the show.
World War One.
It was World War One.
It was a world war. So in a world war, they didn't have moving stairs, and now they have moving stairs. Of course, he's going to be shocked by it.
He's a freaking pilot. He knows what technology could do in the future. Like, it shouldn't be that shocking to him.
And even and his and all his planes had props, and now there's no props. There's only jets. There's a reason to be excited.
Spaghetti strings, I'd be like, wow, that's cool. I wouldn't be like, oh.
I think all I really do. I really do think that you're just a bitter old man.
No,
that's just angry with the world.
The majority of the world agrees with me that this was a hot dumpster fire.
And just find no joy in anything in this life.
I had more joy out of Justice League than this piece of trash.
Justice League was an absolute piece of garbage.
Gal Gadot gives me much joy.
This movie was fun. This was a fun movie.
Nothing fun about it. All of the catcalling, was that fun to you? Did you enjoy that every single man you saw on screen catcalled?
They were
every
rapey.
Single woman every no, single time.
I did enjoy it, but guess what? That's reality.
This is not reality. What world do you live in? Do you catcall every woman you
see?
How many women have you tried to rape, Scott?
I have never watched a woman in public catcalled ever.
Oh, my God. Then you need to get out in public more often. Go to a city once in your lifetime because it happens all the effing time. Pass one construction site and guess what happens all the time?
Where's there a construction site where there are people sitting in their years like a bunch of weirdos? All right.
It's always been going on.
Don't know.
This movie was not good at all.
Me hemorrhoids are acting up.
All fantastic right.
Well,
movie.
That's a terrible movie. You heard it here.
Great we movie.
For you. So anyway, we will review the next one for you folks. Again, we are Our Reviews Will Kill You. Feel free to catch us everywhere. You've seen us. We'll bring you another one. Hopefully, it's better than this garbage.
This was a really good movie.